Hey guys, how are y'all doing? We just came back from a 6-week summer vacation that I had with my kids. In this video, what I want to talk about is how to capture your family trips, your family experiences with a camera without always being glued to your camera. Meaning, have your camera up like this the whole time and you are experiencing reality through a screen. You know, you are going on this trip on a vacation with your family or your friends to experience reality, like what's actually happening. The moment that you do this, you detach yourself from the actual reality you're experiencing and you're living through a screen. You're viewing what you're viewing through a screen, and that takes you out of that moment. Number one is know your destination. In other words, you have to know what you want. So picture yourself at the end of your trip. You've just got home, you unpacked everything. What format would you like to have captured your memories? Would you like to come out with a set of 10 photos that really remind you of everything that you did, like a highlights reel? Would you like 1 to 5 minute video that you can experience later in life? You really have to like get to know yourself and get to know how do you best recall things? How do you best like to experience things? If you don't know your destination, if you don't know what you're looking to get out of the experience, you will not capture the right stuff. You're just gonna be like shooting stuff willy-nilly and not really understanding what it is that you're capturing. It's not gonna be working towards a goal. You wanna know where you're going so you can plan the steps to get there. If you don't know where you're going or you don't know what format you wanna export all your footage in at the end, you will not take the right steps to get there. So before you start doing anything, take your time to think, how could I best document this experience that works for me? Tip number two is have the camera on or off, but never in between. And what do I mean by that? You want to have it on when you want to shoot and off when you're not shooting and away. The most important thing is off and away. Now, you're going to be like, well, what if, you know, when I don't have my camera on me, I end up experiencing something that I want to record? Well, to that, I would say life is not about recording it. You have to focus on living your life, on actually experiencing the moment and appreciating what's around you. If the only way you can experience a moment is by having a camera record it, then you are not actually experiencing that moment. I would say it's actually okay and probably better if you're experiencing something and you don't have the ability to record it. Not everything has to make it to your highlight reel, but what's gonna happen is you're gonna watch those 1 or 2 or 3 clips from the day and you're gonna remember, oh, that was the day when this happened or that happened. So things lead to each other when you come to watching a video later. What really helps me is not having the camera on me at all. Just taking it out for a few minutes here and there and then tossing it aside. And at the end of your trip, if you go for 1, 2, 3, or 4 days, you're gonna have, you know, that many days times 3 or 4 video clips. You're gonna have like maybe 24 or 36 solid clips that you can use for your footage. Tip number three is, even though you're on a vacation or you're going somewhere different, don't forget about good lighting, don't forget about composition, and don't forget about audio. Most important thing in any video is the audio. If the audio is gone, the viewer will not be able to forgive you and they will not enjoy your video. And you are gonna consider yourself the viewer for your own video in the future. If you didn't capture good audio, you're not gonna like it. You're not gonna feel like you're there. Make sure you record good audio. Not bring an external recorder and no. I'm just saying whatever's on site, whatever's there, make sure you capture it. Composition and lighting make the image. Without that, you don't have anything. Look for contrast. Look for different times of the day when the light is great. The next tip, of course, is going to be to know your camera in and out. Know your camera. You don't want to be at the scene, you know, during a trip, fiddling with settings and like, why is this overexposed, underexposed? You want to know your camera inside out. You don't want to waste any time looking at your camera at all or doing settings. I have buttons remapped to all of my most common stuff that I do. For example, I have a button on the top of the camera that is mapped to 5x slow motion, so I can go from shooting normal speed to slow motion with just one button tap. I have photo and video mode completely separate, and they're just literally one button press away, so that I don't have to waste time going through menus and going through photo and video. All of my photo settings are exactly the way they want, and all my video settings are exactly the way they want. Whatever camera you have, even if it's your phone, just know it inside out. You want to have enough knowledge about your camera to use it without even seeing it. Just having it in your hand, eyes closed, you can do all the things that you have to do to go from one mode to the next. That way you're not wasting any time looking at the screen when you're on your trip. Rather, you're actually just capturing what you have to and then putting the camera away and experiencing your trip. When you get back from your trip and you have all of your footage, you have two options. You can either outsource the video editing to someone else to make you a video, or you can do the editing yourself. I would recommend, if you're not an expert at this and you just want to capture your videos into one little one for your family later, I would say just hire someone to do it. Go on Upwork or Fiverr.com. You know, it'll cost you maybe $10, $15. Give them all of your raw footage, put them in a Dropbox link, send it to them, and they will put it all together for you in however many minutes you want. Super easy. It does not take any work at all. Maybe it takes like half an hour to look for someone, to hire them, to give them the footage, and you get back exactly what you wanted. I'm always like an 80-20 rule guy, you know, spend the least effort to get the most results. And in this case, I would say if you were to do it by yourself and you've never done it before, it'll take you at least 3 to 4 hours. The last tip, which is something that I don't really hear people talking about, is once you have all this footage at home on your hard drive from your trip, let's assume it's like 10 gigabytes of footage, just delete it. What I do is, after I edit the video and now I have, you know, a 5-minute video highlight reel of my trip, all that footage that the video was made up from, I just get rid of it. I only keep that 5-minute video. Because what's the point? How many times in the past have I went back and looked at the raw footage from a family trip? It's honestly nothing. That video basically captures the entire experience that I'd ever want to remember. And it's on the cloud, because YouTube saves it. All that raw footage is just gonna take up hard drive space, and over the years you're gonna accumulate so much footage that you're not gonna know what to do with. So my vote is just delete it. Only keep what you need, which is that highlight reel. The rest of it, get rid of it. What that's going to result in is, over the years, you're going to accumulate a solid list of videos that your entire family can look back on and remember all the memories that you guys had and just have some really good moments. That's all I had for today. I'm going to make a ton more videos about future cameras that I'm thinking about getting. But in the meantime, the X100V has just been a blast to use. I mean, I shot so many family gatherings this summer with it, and it's just been like a workhorse of a camera. I cannot recommend this camera enough. But I am looking for something with a little more depth of field, thinking about an X-T4 or maybe a GFX, I don't know. Stay tuned, guys, and thank you so much for watching this far, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.